LPV, LNAV, VNAV, LNAV+V. What do these acronyms mean, and what's the difference? In this video, you'll learn everything you need to know about the different types of GPS approaches. GPS approaches fall into four types: lateral navigation, or LNAV, localizer performance, or LP, lateral navigation and vertical navigation, or LNAV-VNAV, and localizer performance with vertical guidance, or LPV. LNAV approaches are the most basic type, providing lateral guidance only. To fly this procedure, we need an IFR-certified GPS receiver with RAIM and a current navigation database. WAS is not required. How precise is LNAV? The course width is 1 nautical mile left or right of course until 2 nautical miles from the final approach fix, where it narrows to 0.3 nautical miles. Sound familiar? That's the RNP approach nav spec. The width stays the same until the missed approach point. Reaching the course limits results in a full-scale CDI deflection. Since LNAV doesn't provide vertical guidance, we fly the procedure down to a minimum descent altitude, or MDA, just like other non-precision approaches. Next up, we have localizer performance, or LP, procedures. These approaches mimic how a ground-based localizer beam becomes more sensitive the closer we get to the runway. To fly an LP approach, we'll need the improved accuracy of a WAS receiver. Unlike LNAV, the LP course width narrows from 0.3 nautical miles on either side at the final approach fix to typically 350 feet on either side at the missed approach point. These procedures don't offer vertical guidance, so they use an MDA. The last two types are categorized as approaches with vertical guidance, or APVs. APVs are flown to a decision altitude, or DA, similar to an ILS, but are not classified as precision approaches. The most basic APV is LNAV-VNAV. They have the same lateral sensitivity as LNAV, but provide vertical course guidance. LNAV-VNAV used to be available only to aircraft with special barometrically aided equipment, but can now be flown with any WAS-equipped GPS. And finally, we have localizer performance with vertical guidance, or LPV, approaches. These are the most accurate GPS procedures and can provide minimums as low as 200 feet. As you might have guessed, LPV combines the increased lateral sensitivity of an LP approach with vertical guidance. The vertical path scales like an ILS, narrowing to plus or minus 49 feet at the missed approach point. We'll need WAS to fly one. Now, you might be wondering why we didn't include LNAV+V or LP+V. Well, they actually aren't approach types. If we're flying an LNAV or LP approach using a WAS receiver, it might show an advisory vertical glide path. This provides us with a constant rate stabilized descent to minimums. But remember, it's advisory only and not officially part of the approach. It does not provide obstacle protection below the MDA and could take us below step-down altitudes. It's up to us to ensure we don't bust minimums. If you liked this video, you'll love our Instrument Rating Made Easy course. Click the link in the description to learn more. Thanks for watching.